attractive. My aggression isn't passive. I promise with you the butterflies in my stomach are active. They're dancing, I'm feeling static. Wanna get closer like magnets, your company.
Hey you guys, welcome back to my channel. It's your girl Nelly, and I know I haven't done a video in forever, but I'm back and that's all that matters. I'm here now. Okay. So I've created this look using the James Charles palette and a couple shadows from the Juvia Place palette. I'm just be super Valentine's Day, purpley, pinky, cute look for you guys. So if you want to see how I created it or whatever, then feel free to watch. You don't have to, but you should. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Also, you guys, let me know what type of videos I should be gearing more towards doing. I do see that a lot of people are gearing more towards my story time and get ready with me's and stuff like that. So I kind of feel like I should take a break from makeup and like focus on that. But let me know down below. Yeah, let's get to the video. Okay, so I did my brows off camera per usual. So the first thing I'm gonna start out with is the Urban Decay eyeshadow primer potion. This little thing right here, I picked it up the other day, and to be honest, the only reason I bought it was because I have the James Charles palette and he's like, you can't use concealer, you're not supposed to use concealer. Although I did use concealer the first time I used it and it came out bomb. I'll insert a picture. And the second time I used concealer, I just didn't like how it was looking. It wasn't blending correctly. So I was like, okay, let me listen to this man. It's his product. I don't know how much I'm supposed to put on. He already know what it is. So let me just follow what he says. Now, I don't know what you're supposed to do with this, but my fingers. Just this little purple looking color. And I want to take that and just start, place it right above the crease, right there. And just go in a windshield wiper motion and brush that onto my eyelids. So I'm leaving enough space so I could add in a brow color, a brow highlight, sorry. So just take that and just windshield wiper motion and blend that out. I'm going for like a purpley pink type look. I don't know yet. We'll see where this look takes us. So just go in, doing light circles and windshield wiper motions, okay? You really want to make sure that you're working on the blend and you're literally just following the shape of your eye. And once you've got the shape down pat, that's when you want to go in and take more eyeshadow and just stamp it on the shape that you've already created so you can intensify that color. Then go again with that windshield wiper motion. So then I'm going to take this Morphe brush right here and that color, I'm going to focus it on in my crease. So right below here. Could step back so you guys could see. So right here. I focus that on that area. So what I like to do, because I'm a beginner, I like to focus more on actually just placing the shadow first and then blending. So I have it placed in my crease. I'm going to be using the same windshield wiper motion. I'm going to close my eyes, kind of look down a little bit so I get that little, I get a sense of where my brush is placing and just blend that baby out. Morphe brush, it doesn't have a name on it. So I'm going to more stamp this on than anything. I'm not going to like do any type of sweeping motion. I'm just going to stamp it on for now. I think just looking at it now, I'm going to bring the purple a little bit further inwards. Always step back and kind of look at how your shadow look, both on camera and the mirror, different lighting, just to see how it's looking, if you like it. Like, I'm going to use my bigger mirror right now to see what is going on. And if so, now it's at a place where I like, I'm loving it. So I'm going to go ahead and cut the crease. I'm using the Tarte Shape Tape in Dark Deep Honey, and the way how I like to cut my crease, I just like to go ahead and get a whole bunch of eyeshadow and just make these little lines right here and then like go like this, or you could just simply look up, but I'm extra, so go like that, and then it already creates the crease for you or where it should be laid for you. So that's amazing, that's cool. And I want to bring it out right to where I have this little purple shade. I might bring it out later, we'll see. And that's pretty much my cut crease, and then I just go in and I fill in all the little spaces. So I went ahead and cut my crease on such a pretty color. Let me come even closer. the Magic Minis by Juvia's Place palette, and I'm gonna go in with Osen. No, I don't use that. I lied. Zuba. We're gonna go in Zuba, this little pink shade right here. Right on the side. Okay. So now it's more gold than pink. Wow. Bear with me, you guys. Okay, so next I'm gonna go in with the foundation by NARS. It's gonna be in the color Cadiz. I can't pronounce that, but I'm gonna go in with this. Since my eye is like super heavy, I'm gonna go in with something lighter and more glowy. And yeah. What is happening? There's a ghost in this room. So next I'm gonna take the Born This Way multi-use sculpting concealer in the color Honey. I'm gonna use that to highlight. I'm gonna blend out that with a sponge, and I'm just gonna go in the regular highlight areas, focusing more on the under eyes than anywhere else because I really want that to pop. And I'm also gonna take the concealer before I go ahead and blend out my concealer. Just gonna let it sit there, let it dry, and then next, I'm gonna go in with baking powder. I'm gonna be using the Hourglass, Veil Transition Setting Powder. I'm using this powder instead of my Laura Mercier powder because I want to keep my skin looking skin-like and just super glowy. I really don't wanna get rid of all this glow that's going on. So I'm gonna take that, I'm gonna bake for about 5 minutes. I'm using that same sponge that I used to blend out with my concealer. Before I even go in with the powder, I'm just gonna make sure that I'm not creasing anywhere, which I am. I do crease really fast. So take that and I'm gonna apply it as close to the lash line as possible. This will probably be easier with like a mini beauty blender, but I'm not applying a lot of powder, just a sheer small amount. And you want to apply that powder to all the places that you know you're going to get oily at and crease at. And for me, that's going to be my smile lines right here, my chin, my nose, all the typical basic areas. Next, I'm going to go in and dust off all the excess powder. I'm using this unmarked beauty blush. It's just an angled brush. And dust it off. Once I've dusted off all the powder, I'm gonna go ahead with a powder that's the same color as my skin. Right now, this is the MAC Studio Fix in NW45. And I'm just gonna take that and just lightly go over all the places that I highlighted. So we're gonna go ahead and apply that to my chin a little bit, my forehead, just basically everywhere I highlighted, just to make sure that everything looks even and nothing is too bright. And also I see that I have some powder left underneath my eyes. I'm going to take it and just sweep it off. That. So next I'm going to go in with the Kat Von D Shade Plus Light palette. And I'm going to take the color Subconscious. I'm going to take this white tall brush by Morphe and use that to contour my cheeks. I'm also going to take this Y2 brush, also by Morphe, and just use that to blend out my contour. So I'm blending in circular motions and I'm it's counter-circular, counter-clockwise motions, and pushing the powder more towards my ear than towards my mouth. And there's currently no powder on this brush, so whatever that came off using that first brush is what I'm using. And then I will build on afterwards. So I'm also going to take this and go ahead and do the same thing for my jawline, for my forehead, and then we'll come back to the other brush for my nose. Again, going back in with the Y12 brush and dusting off the excess, I'm just going to use that to lightly contour my nose. And then going back in with the other brush, really blend out the powder and making sure that it's seamless. I'm also going to use the Shade Plus Light palette. And I'm going to use the color, I dabble between, what is this? It's kind of hard to read it on the back. Levitation and Lyric. I'm going to take this Y11 brush by Morphe and just use that to highlight underneath my eyes just to make it even more brighter. That's up to you if you want to. You could just stay with your regular Laura Mercier powder. But I just like the way how this photographs. It gives me kind of a seamless finish underneath my eyes. It kind of brightens it more. I believe there's like little like glow. I don't know. But it just makes my under eyes look better and I feel better about it. Also, I threw it down my nose as well. I just feel like it puts everything together. And then if I accidentally apply too much of that skin like powder, that Studio Fix powder, then it kind of just brings everything back to the way it looks before. But be careful not to go in with too much if you do get this palette, because you will be looking ghostly. That's about it. So next, before we go in with blush, a quick tip. When you've applied so much powder to your face, if you just went through baking, just went through the Studio Fix, more powder after that, bronzing, you want to make sure that to one, keep that skin like finish, and to two, make your makeup last longer, you want to go in with a setting spray. More so a light setting spray, so don't go in with something so heavy like the Urban Decay setting spray. Like, just the dewy even mist could even work. I'm gonna use the Little Mario facial spray and spray that all over my face. And then take some type of piece of paper, some type of fan, and you're gonna fan that in like so. If you're like me, I'm using my whole enforcement little thing. See, that's my car going through the tools. So next we're going to go in with blush. I'm going to be using the Anastasia Beverly Hills Blush Trio, and I'm going to be using the color Ginger. Yeah, I'm going to use Ginger. Actually, I'm going to mix Ginger and Nectarine, these two, and I'm using an angled Morphe blush brush. There you go. And I'm just going to apply that to my cheeks. So next, I'm going to go in and spray my face again before I go in with my highlighter. So the highlighter that I'm using is going to be the Becca Cosmetics. It's in the color Topaz. So this little golden baby right here. I wanted something more skin-like again, something that's not super chalky or drying. And then I'm going to take the highlighter on a Y14 Morphe brush and just go in really lightly at first, just figuring out where I really want to place this. I apply that first layer, so next I'm going to go in and really coat my brush with some highlighter. Then I'm going to take some type of setting spray, get my brush wet, just give it a quick tap tap, and then you go in and it's going to give you that wet kind of blinding look, as you guys can see right here. Just a trick of mama to do. I actually learned it from Mama Michelle on Instagram when he did Jeffree Star's makeup. So it's quick. The lips. I'm gonna go in with this. Oh, this is actually my Kylie pencil. Okay, I guess. So the Kylie Jenner True Brown Lip Liner. I originally was gonna go in with Pat McGrath Ground Control, but here we are. Use that. And just use that to line the outer sections of my lips. So we've got the lip line. I'm looking kind of crazy right now. And we're going to go in with a pink lipstick. I hate pink lipstick, but for the culture, we'll do it. This is Humble Pie by ColourPop. And this is Fuchsia Pink. Just, I don't, I'm disgusted right now. And I'm going to put that in the center and then blend it out. Oh my god. Okay, so this is how it looks right now. I'm going to fix this up because the pink. So last but not least, to set this look, we're going to go ahead with the Urban Decay All Nighter Spray. And then take your paper and fan that mofo. Alright, fan, make it dry. If you feel that someplace like dries too fast, spray some more on it. You can never have too much. But yes.
They're so cute.
That's pretty much it for the look. I did go ahead and put some pink eyeshadow underneath my eyes just to make that pop and kind of bring everything together. But that's pretty much it. We're gonna go ahead and take this off and I'll be right back.
Sorry if it's hard to catch my vibe. I need a lover to trust. Tell me you're on my side. Are you down for the ride? It's not easy for someone to catch my eye.
So that's pretty much it for the final look, you guys. I was trying to do something more simple, but it got real dramatic real quick. But that's okay. We still look cute. We're going to roll with it. Please make sure that you guys like, comment, and subscribe. I'm going to leave all the information down below. Every product that I use will also be listed. It might not be listed right when I upload the video, but check back in 5 to 3 business days, and it will be there. That's pretty much it. Peace out.